All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Elmer Stewart, the CEO of Copper Fox. And Elmer, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Good to see you again as well.
So some news out this morning from the company regarding the Schaft Creek project. And maybe just remind everyone a little bit about that project and sort of, I know you did some drilling and we'll talk about it in just a second, but overall the project itself.
It's Schaft Creek is a joint venture between Teck Resources Limited, and they own 75%, and Copper Fox owns a 25% interest in the project. Teck is the operator, and Copper Fox is of the opinion that's a great idea because a project of this scale, as you're aware, the preliminary economic assessment pegged a daily throughput at 133,000 tons a day. And that basically puts it into a certain class of projects that are, it's one of the bigger ones on the drawing board out there.
And so they completed a drill program. Tell us a bit about what they were looking at with this program.
The purpose of the program was to do additional drilling across the three mineralized zones at Schaft Creek, because the previous work that was done from a metallurgical perspective was good. It gave us some distribution, but the review in the 2021 PEA clearly indicated that we need more variability sampling across the deposit. And the reason why you need that is that the variability sample, metallurgical work, will allow the ability to determine the recoveries, better inform the recoveries across the deposit. It'll better inform the geometallurgical characteristics across the deposit. And that all, believe it or not, goes to two things. It basically lets you know that the process you've developed, you can achieve your throughput based on that because you need to know the geometallurgical characteristics. At the same time, it will give you a better projection of future metal production. So very important work that was done. It was a very successful program. We did the work we thought necessary. And as the joint venture has always done, we don't spend money that we don't think we need to have to get to achieve the results we want.
Yeah. And Elmer, part of that, I mean, that was, 11 holes and about almost 5,000 meters, but there was also a lot of other field work that was going on around that as well.
There was. And, the thing is that geotechnical aspects of those cores were collected. And, some of the work setting up for future programs was also done during the work. And we're also pushing forward on the environmental aspects, because as you know, permitting is a large portion of any project in Canada, especially resource projects. And you need to make sure that the data you collect is in line of the requirements. And it also, the idea is to make sure if and when the project ever goes to the permitting process, and we all hope it does, or at least Copper Fox hopes it does, the data we collect has to be what's needed to meet the both federal and provincial requirements.
I noticed that in the program, you also they're going to work on the climate stations there as well. Why is that so significant?
Well, that's part of the information that would go into the permitting process, but also more importantly, one of the things we're working in areas where you have four seasons, especially Northern British Columbia, the amount of annual precipitation is very important to know from a perspective of advancing your project. But at the other time, if you're, say you're planning in February, I want to start the project in mid-May. Now we have a camera on site. They can see what the snow conditions are. The snow conditions are, say you got 3 feet of snow, well, you can't go in there mid-May. But the thing is, if you got no snow, well, then you say, okay, guys, let's mobilize. It's just a very helpful thing to allow future operations to get going, predict when you should start and when you can start.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense when you explain it like that. Go ahead, Elmer.
And some of the other activities that have been completed this year, they've upgraded to some of the camp facilities too for future programs. And clearly, I assume that's in anticipation of a bigger program in the future, possibly 2023. That has not been decided yet. That has not been set out by the operator. And we're anticipating we'll see here something along that line toward the end of 2022 for what they're expected to do in 2023.
All right, we'll wait to hear that. Elmer, thanks so much for the update. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. Have a good day.
Yeah, Elmer Stewart, the CEO of Copper Fox.